The COVID-19 pandemic has turned our lives upside down, leaving millions infected and 100,000s dead.
So how does COVID-19 lead to severe illness? And how it kills?
The story starts with SARS-CoV-2, the virus that causes the coronavirus disease 2019, as known as the COVID-19.
It enters our respiratory system, down from trachea to our lungs. It invades into this tiny alveoli, which function to expel carbon dioxide and bring in oxygen. When it reaches our alveoli, it binds to the type 2 lung cell's ACE2 receptor and uses the cell to replicate more viruses. To protect other cells, the infected cell will undergo apoptosis, a programmed cell death. It then triggers an immune cell called macrophage that eats up pathogens to release cytokines, proteins for cell-to-cell communication, which some promote inflammation. The cytokines will recruit more immune cells such as neutrophils and monocytes. The immune cells then trigger more release of pro-inflammatory cytokines. In normal times, the release of cytokines is regulated, but for severe patients, an excessive number of cytokines are released. When it loses control, this is called a cytokine storm. As a result, many neutrophils are recruited and they secrete reactive oxygen species, which was aimed to kill the pathogens, but too much of it damages our lung cells. Many doctors and researchers believe that the cytokine storm is one of the main causes for severe COVID-19 illness. The cells of alveoli are damaged, serious inflammation will occur, and our blood capillaries will become highly permeable. Liquid filled with proteins and immune cells will flood into our alveoli. Inflammation and damaged cells limits our respiration and our lungs can contract and relax. This is when the ventilator steps in. Some patients develop acute respiratory distress syndrome, or ARDS. It is very fatal. ACE2 receptor is also present on the cell lining of the blood vessels. When the virus binds with ACE2, the ACE2 receptor is now unable to degrade a hormone called angiotensin II. The increased concentration of angiotensin II stimulates the formation of more reactive oxygen species. This will damage our blood vessels and trigger inflammation. Consequently, many severe patients have blood clots all around their blood vessels.
This might lead to stroke, amputations, heart attacks, multi-organ failure, and even deaths.
What if someone survived from severe illness? Doctors warn that some severely ill patients might have long-lasting consequences. Lungs, brains, kidneys, heart, etc. may not fully recover, and some may suffer mentally.
Just like fighting the war, the more you know about your enemy, the better you can fight off. Roger that.
It has only been a short time since the first COVID-19 case, and more mystery about the virus is yet to be discovered. In the end, no matter how hard this pandemic hits us, there is still hope for tomorrow.